Hello and welcome to Digital Goulash. My name is Chucky, and today I'm going to be covering the new feature in the Photoshop Elements 9 that pretty much does away with all my other tutorials on doing the 3D pop effect. If you have Photoshop Elements 9, this is a real easy way to pop your pictures out of a frame. Let's go ahead and take a look. I'd like to give credit to Linolfian here. I always use this photo for the 3D pop effect. So let's go ahead and take a look at how we can do this. Once you have your file open, you can do that from your organizer, or you can go to File, Open. Now, of course, this is Photoshop Elements 9. Go more underneath the Edit. On the right-hand side, there's one that says Full, Quick, and then Guided. At the very bottom, there's one that's called Fun Edits. So if you scroll your scroll bar all the way down to the bottom, you have Fun Edits. If you don't see it, there's a little arrow there that you can twist, and then you can see that there are 5 different Fun Edits, which are actually pretty fun. Let's go ahead and look at the Out of Bounds, because that's actually the 3D pop effect. And when you click it, it gives you the before and after of what a picture could look like. Gives you a link to an online video tutorial, but I'm going to take you through that, so you can watch that one. You can also watch mine. And then it's going to take you step by step on how to create this particular effect. Now I'm going to scroll down a bit, and then I'm going to click on Add a Frame. And you can see right here it adds a frame to your photo. I'm going to kind of move that frame around so that part of her head and part of her arm are actually sticking outside of the what would be normally the picture. Now if you hold the Command or Control button and you grab hold of the corners, you can kind of distort this effect a little bit to give it that 3D look. So if you go and grab each corner and then hold down the Control or the Command button, you can kind of give it that 3D effect. Now once you're happy with what your picture is going to look like and the head and the arm are sticking out of the frame, click on the green checkbox to commit those particular changes. Now the next thing is, I'm not sure if it's really confusing or not, but if you look at the marching ants, we're going to put a little edge on this to make it look like it is a photograph. So you can see that there is a white border. If you want to increase the size of the white border, you can kind of just pull down on this, and as you can see, each one of the sides is going to increase just a little bit. Just that white edge is going to increase. Now once you're happy with that white edge, we click the green checkbox again to commit those changes. Then you can actually start seeing your photo. Let's go ahead and scroll down a little bit so that I can follow along with the tutorial here. That's pretty much what it said, was to put a frame there and then skew it a little bit. Now when you get down to the bottom, there is one that says Quick Selection Tool. You're going to click on the Quick Selection Tool. I'm going to click on the plus sign up here, and then I'm going to start from the inside and I'm going to trace around her where I want her popping out. Now you don't have to do any more than just a little bit of the inside and then most of the, all the outside here. I'm going to start inside here and then I'm going to click on her arm. Now I have to go back and I have to click the minus sign because I need to take some of that green out. There we go. So now I just have her arm selected here and I have the top of her head selected there. Now that's all I really need to do. I'm going to go down and I'm going to scroll down here, and if I click on Create Out of Bounds, it's going to do it automatically for me. So if I click here, it says Create Out of Bounds, and as you can see, she is popping out of the frame. Now of course I picked a picture that was very difficult because she has a lot of flyaway hair, so if you're doing this you might want to stick to a foot or a shoe or a ball or something like that that you can trace very easily. Now I'm going to scroll down a little bit more. You can add some style to this by adding a drop shadow. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's not so good. So I add that. It looks okay. Kind of has a little bit of a drop shadow that goes all around there. That's kind of nice. I'm going to actually add a gradient here. I do like a gradient. I'm going to select gradient here. And as you can see, it put kind of a gradient on there. It's kind of a nice gradient. It starts with white and goes to gray. Now, if you don't like that particular gradient, you can double click inside the gradient editor and you can move the stops over here. So maybe you want a little bit more gray. Maybe you want, the middle gradient to move just a little bit. And then when I'm happy with it, I can select OK. Now you can see there's a white piece right here, and then it goes to gray. So it now looks like she is popping out of this picture in 3D right there. And it's pretty much the same thing that I'm doing on my 3D pop effect. And it's very easy now because you can just go through this guided tour and you can use the out of bound feature and do it that way. So this is Chucky from Digital Goulash. I hope you like the 3D pop effect the new way in Photoshop Elements 9. If you like this video, please click on the like and then subscribe to me if you haven't done so already. Take care.